Hello, and welcome to Software Architecture Monday. My name is Mark Richards. I'm a hands-on software architect and also the founder of developer2architect.com. In today's lesson, Lesson 34, we'll take a look at creating service domains. Now, in the last lesson, Lesson 33, I talked about creating a service taxonomy. What I'd like to do now is show similar techniques on creating service domains. When we take a look at microservices here, this is a very typical illustration of a microservices topology where we have client requests coming into an API layer that then in turn forward that request into each individual separately deployed microservice, all owning their own data. One of the things that's missing in these kind of topology diagrams like this is the identification of domains. And let me explain what I mean. When we talk about a small number of services, we usually don't have to worry about creating service domains because we can really manage and control those number of services. Where we start to run into trouble with this architecture style, microservices, is when we start creating more services. As we start to create more services, that API layer hence expands to cover all the various operations of those services. And now we get one big ball of mud. There's complications in terms of repos, in terms of teams, in terms of organization of services, and also the control and management of those services. And so one of the techniques is identifying service domains when we start to have any number of services above, let's say, 8 or 9. As a matter of fact, I like to start creating service domains right away because when we start to look at this many services and look at how I separated those out, there are definable groups of services. For example, the services on the left-hand side, these groups are all the customer-related services. The ones here are all the shipping microservices. These services right here all have to do with the order processing of the website. These ones have to do with payment processing in terms of like making a payment, refunds, credits, so on and so forth. And finally, customer tracking and management over on that side. And so as you can see, as we start to grow our microservices ecosystem, we start to form these domains. We still have a problem, though, because we have a single API layer. And this may seem a little silly. However, I have seen in the field where as we start to grow the number of services, we start to dynamically grow our single API layer as well. And this could be either a gateway or just a simple API proxy, such as Nginx or IIS or even Squid or HA proxy, for example. So the API layer, by the way, holds all of those RESTful endpoints. And so we've got all the customer shipping, order processing, payment, and tracking operations all going into the same API layer, even though we have kind of logically partition these. So let me show you a couple of techniques for creating service domains in a physical type of manifestation. The first one that I really like is to leverage this API layer as a federated API. Now, this not only serves the problem of eliminating a single point of failure and also performance bottlenecks and also scalability issues with the number of customer operations versus tracking operations, but also if you see here, now we have well-defined API layers that have all the RESTful endpoints that have to do with that particular domain. And this is one technique without having to modify any of your source code of being able to define a grouping of services. And so now we've got customer operations going into a customer API layer, a shipping API, an order processing API, a payment API, and a tracking API. So now when we run the documentation, if I want to know what tracking operations there are, I go to a single API and a single API documentation. Now, this is a good first step, but let me show you another way, a technique that I typically use of identifying service domains. And that is a very similar technique that I introduced in the prior lesson, Lesson 33, on creating a service taxonomy. And that's the use of these identity annotations. For example, in Java, I might create an identity annotation defining each domain. And these are functional domains. And so I've got the retention on runtime, the target based on the class, and now I've got an annotation defined here, for example, as customer domain. The entry point class of each service, for example, in this case, this is the customer notification service, would carry that annotation with it so that programmatically, I can now determine what groups of services belong to the customer domain, irrespective of my team structure or also my repo or my repository structure. And so now if we come back to this example, let's start on the left-hand side. All of those microservices that have to do with customer would all carry that customer domain annotation. Similar, shipping would carry a shipping domain, an order domain, a payment domain, and finally a tracking domain. And so now, not only do I have logical groupings, but I've delimited those by the API layer to simplify those operations, and also now by a programmatic way of determining any given service, what is its domain. So this is a great way of being able to provide, kind of like I said, a physical manifestation onto creating service domains. So you can get more information by going to developer2architect.com. As a matter of fact, all of the lessons, this is lesson 34, but all of the lessons are in developer2architect.com lessons. This is just a little snapshot of other kinds of material that I do a little bit of a deeper dive on. So if you go to developer2architect.com/upcoming events, you can see where I am in terms of training, conferences, and certain events and those topics that I'm speaking on. And also, of course, I do have my 3-day architecture fundamentals course. It's a hands-on course publicly done through NFJS, No Fluff, Just Stuff, and you can go to the link there to actually get more information and register. So this has been Lesson 34, Creating Service Domains. Again, my name is Mark Richards. Thanks for listening, and stay tuned next Monday for a next architecture lesson. Thank you.